says Mission Control Houston, with a look back of this week in space. On Monday, Expedition 29 crew members Anton Shkaplerov, Anatoly Ivanishin, and Dan Burbank were on their way to the International Space Station after having launched aboard the Soyuz TMA-22 spacecraft from Baikonur Cosmodrome in Kazakhstan at 10:14 p.m. Central Time. That was last Sunday. Meanwhile, on Monday, aboard the orbiting outpost, Commander Mike Fossum had worked with the Space Dynamically Responding Ultrasonic Matrix System. This is also known as Space Drums, a suite of hardware that uses sound waves to allow experiment samples to be processed without ever touching a container wall. This allows materials to be produced in microgravity with an unparalleled quality of shape and composition. The goal there is to develop advanced materials of a commercial quantity and quality and help improve manufacturing processes here on Earth. Fossum had also participated in the Integrated Resistance and Aerobic Training Study known as SPRINT, which involves ultrasound imagery taking of his leg and a shorter, more intense workout on the advanced resistive exercise device than station crew members normally perform. The SPRINT evaluates the use of high-intensity, low-volume exercise training to minimize loss of muscle, bone, and cardiovascular function in station crew members during those long-duration missions. Fossum is the first to participate in this new protocol. Additionally, he had worked with the binary colloidal alloy test 6 science payload in this experiment, also known as the BCAT-6. Station crew members photographed samples of polymer and colloidal particles as they change from liquids to gases to model that phase change. The results will help scientists develop fundamental physics concepts previously cloaked by the effects of gravity. Also on Monday, flight engineer Satoshi Furukawa analyzed water samples from the station's water recovery system, which recycles urine to produce potable water. And flight engineer Sergei Volkov had worked with the radiation payload suite. The Russian payload is designed for sophisticated radiation studies and is named after the traditional Russian set of nested dolls, Matryoshka. Next, on Tuesday, the Expedition 29 crew members living and working aboard the International Space Station had wrapped up an abbreviated workday Tuesday morning as they prepared to welcome three new crewmates arriving aboard a Soyuz spacecraft that occurred early Wednesday morning. With only a week left in their mission aboard the orbiting complex, the three outgoing Expedition 29 crew members spent some time Tuesday packing up for their return aboard the Soyuz TMA-02M spacecraft that brought them to the station on June 9th. Fossum also checked on the binary colloidal alloy test science payload, which takes a look at those colloids, those microscopic particles suspended in a liquid. Also, meanwhile, Furukawa closed the shutters on some of the windows in the U.S. and Japanese segments of the station to protect them from contamination from exhaust plumes of the Soyuz as it rendezvoused with the station. Then on Tuesday, Volkov had spent several hours working with a cell cultivation experiment known as Cascade, and later he had performed some routine maintenance on the life support system in the Russian segment of the station. On Wednesday, Expedition 29 expanded to six crew members. NASA astronaut Dan Burbank and Russian cosmonauts Anton Shkaplerov and Anatoly Ivanishin docked their Soyuz TMA-22 spacecraft to the Poisk mini-research module at 11:24 a.m. Central Time on Wednesday. They are scheduled to live in space until March of this year. Expedition 29 Commander Mike Fossum and Flight Engineers Satoshi Furukawa and Sergei Volkov welcomed their new crewmates when the hatches were opened at 1:39 a.m. Central Time on Wednesday morning. After that welcoming ceremony with mission officials and family members, the station residents conducted the standard crew safety briefing. The new crew members familiarized themselves with potential hazards, safety equipment locations, and escape routes. On Wednesday, Burbank had prepared for a pair of experiments that observe a crew member's adaptation to microgravity. For the integrated immune experiment, he would be providing saliva samples to help scientists develop immune monitoring strategies for long-duration missions. Another experiment, known as the reaction self-test, will require the new flight engineer to take a short test which measures fatigue resulting from the disruption of the circadian rhythm while living and working in space. On Thursday, the Expedition 29 crew members focused on orientation activities and science experiments during their first full day as a six-member crew. after docking in the Soyuz TMA-22 spacecraft on the early Wednesday morning, the station's newest residents, flight engineers Dan Burbank, Anton Shkaplerov, and Anatoly Ivanishin, focused on a variety of orientation activities to familiarize themselves with their new home aboard the orbiting outpost. The three new flight engineers also met with the rest of the Expedition 29 crew to review emergency roles and responsibilities. The station crew members have little less than a week together as the Expedition 29 crew before Fossum, Furukawa, and Volkov head home on Monday aboard the Soyuz TMA-02M spacecraft that brought them to the station last summer on June 9th. Their departure will mark the beginning of Expedition 30 under the command of Dan Burbank. A formal change of command ceremony is planned for Sunday. Also on Thursday in the Destiny Laboratory, Fossum had replaced and reconfigured equipment inside the combustion integrated rack, which is part of the fluids and combustion facility. The combustion integrated rack is an experiment facility that helps researchers study how different materials can combust in the microgravity environment aboard the station and can be operated by crew members or remotely by researchers on Earth. Also on Thursday, Anatoly Ivanishin had worked with a Russian experiment known as Cascade, which investigates the cultivation processes of microorganism, animal, and human cells in microgravity, while his Russian cosmonaut crewmates Volkov and Shkaplerov set aside some time to work with a variety of experiments, including Plasmida, a Russian bioecology experiment that will examine the effect of microgravity on the rate of transfer and mobilization of bacteria plasmids. And later yesterday, Fossum and Burbank had took some time to talk with Kevin Reese from KHOU-TV in Houston during an in-flight interview. And finally today, on Friday, November 18, Commander Fossum and Burbank worked together on maintenance to the waste hygiene compartment. Fossum also provided some handover instruction to Burbank on the binary colloidal alloy test. Those are the series of ongoing science experiments that looks at those microscopic particles that are suspended in a liquid, and they may one day lead to improvements in manufacturing processes here on Earth. Together, Fossum and Burbank worked to unpack the U.S. items that were brought up by Burbank and his crewmates aboard the Soyuz. Burbank reviewed the operations of the onboard stationary bicycle as exercise to mitigate the effects of spaceflight, which is essential during a long-duration flight. And earlier this morning, in preparation for the return to Earth, Sergei Volkov and Satoshi Furukawa participated in a conference with specialists on the ground to review their upcoming descent to Earth aboard the Soyuz TMA-02M spacecraft. Fossum, Volkov, and Furukawa are scheduled to land in Kazakhstan Monday, November 21, at 8:24 p.m. Central Time, 9:24 p.m. Eastern Time. Just during the hour, Commander Mike Fossum had performed some preventative maintenance to the oxygen generator system along with Dan Burbank. He had spent some time cleaning filters and removing and replacing a hydrogen sensor. Flight engineer, soon to assume command of the International Space Station, Dan Burbank was busy unpacking items that were brought up with he and his crews aboard the Soyuz. Flight engineers Sergei Volkov and Anton Shkaplerov have been participating in space station handover reviews, while flight engineer Satoshi Furukawa transferred some acoustic measurement data after performing a sound level meter survey of the oxygen generator system, the water recovery system, and also of the Japanese pressurized module. He had later followed that data transfer with an hour of his exercise. Later today, the six station crew members will have completed their 2 hours of their daily exercise. They will participate in a conference with the station flight director, some evening prep work, a conference with the station flight director, and wind down their day with mealtime, hygiene, and rest. Anatoly Ivanishin will then perform some regular maintenance to the Russian life support system known as SOJ. The three new crew members will continue to settle into their home and adjust to their microgravity living space. The Expedition 29 crew is then scheduled to go to bed at 4:30 p.m. Central Time. This is Mission Control Houston.